2009 United States Department of Energy's Solar Decathlon.
An interdisciplinary, interinstitutional research project. It involves University of Waterloo, Ryerson University in Toronto, and Simon Fraser University, Vancouver, British Columbia.
It's also a continuing research project trying to explore some new technologies, sort of a high-tech sustainability.
In this case, there's an interesting push and pull between the way that design ambition or technical reality feed back against one another to shape a project as it emerges.
It's a house where every day on site it continues to be a tool. Something that doesn't work will show up very quickly. There's an honesty about construction where if it works, if it fits, it's an immediate response. It's not something that you can sit on for a couple days and say, it might be better when we go back and take a look at it again.
Being able to see all the work that it takes to integrate structural systems with building envelope systems, with mechanical systems, control strategies, all of the various technologies that have tons of hiccups and unanticipated parameters and constraints that all come up against each other and all need to be negotiated. Some of them complement each other very easily, some of them have dimensional conflicts or spatial conflicts or performance conflicts. Each of those things needs to be worked out and resolved.
I think what's most exciting about the use of controls in our project centers around the fundamental proposition that in order to generate buildings that are utilized more sustainably by their inhabitants, beyond simply designing technologies that advance various sustainable agendas, we may begin to see the benefit of utilizing control systems that provide immediate feedback to users of the building.
The relationship with MCM, our custom contractor and fabricator, is fantastic. They're an extremely talented, motivated, and driven group of people. They've been able to work with us, work with our design, improve our design, and together we've been able to get the best possible result. It's fully collaborative, and there's enough leeway on both sides that we can really make the right decisions on the project.
Brad and I have both been working closely with MCM, and he has a lot of expertise in terms of how to do things, standard ways of doing things, as well as creative ways of approaching problems.
Probably my relationship with Chloe is among the closest on the team, because Chloe has all of the information. She keeps dimensions in her head. She knows the project. She knows how things should fit. She has this ability to visualize the project and know projections and know how something should look.
Best case scenario is everything crosses the border on time without any problems. We talk to hundreds and thousands of people about solar homes, about what's possible, just opening people's minds to the things that they can do with housing technology.
We all need to just commit ourselves to getting this project done and seeing it happen on the Mall in Washington on October 1st.
I think we've won already. I think the process of exploration, about the process of doing something new, about the process of the break from the conventional, that one is challenged to do something more in the recognition that things don't always have to be as they were.